So we'll pull that off the consent agenda item. Is anybody in the audience regarding those items, which would be Conan Winters, Attorney at Law, Parlor Salon, Spirit Halloween, opposed to those applications that would like to be heard? So we can address those items except 5D, if you'd like to make a motion to approve those items on consent.
Move approval.
Second.
Motion made and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Let's address item 5D. Is the applicant here from Sugar River Bank, ATM? Nope, Suzanne?
Yeah, I guess my question.
Yeah, let's read it into the record, sorry.
Application by Sugar River Bank, ATM, on behalf of Rummy's Block LLC, requesting ADR approval to install a new projecting sign at 152 North Main Street in the Central Business Performance District.
Well, I kind of had the same question that wasn't answered from Design Review, and I guess the question was, is the bank going in there, or is this, are we advertising a little special nook for an ATM?
It's just an ATM.
And then I guess because of that, I was wondering, how does that fit into like our sign regulations? Because I know that if you have, I mean, could we have a proliferation of these little things? I mean, because usually it's associated with the bank. I have not seen one
standalone
as a little business. And how does that relate to the business? I mean, from the picture, there's no elevation of the building. There's like a little perspective going down the sidewalk. And so is it open? I mean, I'm assuming it has a door and you have to use your little key to get in. But it's not a business. So does someone have like a vending machine area that you can put a sign on?
So Craig Walker determines whether or not these comply with the code and whether they're, how they comply. So he reviewed this, he signed off on it. I assume that he's using the storefront, and the amount of signage that is permitted would be based on the storefront or the amount of space that's there. So I'm not sure the exact calculus that goes into figuring out, you know, for instance, the other business. So this is, I believe, sort of an inset, and it's just an ATM. I don't even know that there is a glass. I think it may just be an inset. I'm not positive about that.
It's not precedent setting. I know that Lake Central Bank has one a little farther down towards Southern. There is a sign that we approved back 2 years ago, but it's against the wall. It's not hanging out.
It's not hanging out.
And all that is just an ATM.
So it has its own storefront so that it wouldn't impact someone actually renting the storefront?
Right.
I think it's part of the alcove that goes into the center part of the building. So there's still the storefronts. We're still going to see signage coming before us for those as well.
Is that? Yeah, because I guess I'm not knowing the elevation and exactly what building. That's the corner building.
Correct.
And
the corner building, but the ATM is going to be halfway up the building, halfway south.
Okay. All right.
Okay. All right. There's no public piece of that, right?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think there's anybody here for Sugar River Bank for sign, right? Any comments from the public? Okay, so we have a motion to grant that.
Second.
Motion's been made and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. So let's open up public hearing section under item 6. We've got site plan and subdivision applications. Let's get 6A into the record.
Richard D. Bartlett and Associates, on behalf of George Murray, requesting minor subdivision approval for a 2-lot subdivision at 9 Hot Hole Pond Road in the Residential Business District. Staff does recommend that this application be determined complete, and then we open the public hearing.
Okay, we've got a determination of completeness component for this, so we'll need a motion to approve that.
So moved.
So that motion has been made and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. We'll open up the public hearing. Good afternoon, good evening, gentlemen. Could you state your name for the record?
Good evening, my name is Mark Sargent. I'm with Richard Bartlett and Associates.
George Murray.
Everyone's here to see you guys.
Yeah. I'm trying to get the plant that. Yeah, okay, here we go.
Well, good evening, everybody. The property that we're speaking of this evening is located at 9 Hot Hole Pond Road. It has a total area of 16.2 acres, and I'm just showing a portion of it in the plan view. If you look up into the location map there, you can see the entire piece of property. It has frontage on both Pothole Pond Road and Shaker Road. This parcel was originally subdivided in 1982. If you don't mind, I'm going to pass these.